What's up, guys? I'm bringing you another episode of MPH. It's your boy Biqua, and I got a special guest with me, MikeWoo.
What's going on, guys? Man, Brian, thank you for having me today. I go by the name of MikeWoo, born and raised in San Francisco. Yeah, excited to be here.
For sure, man. So I know you do a lot of things, like DJing, working. Like, what are you up to right now?
Yeah, so during the day, I'm in tech recruiting. So that's been kind of like the 9-to-5 grind. And then at night, you know, I'll be throwing events, spinning all around San Francisco. Just kind of pushing my collective called Friends.
Nice. How did that come about, man?
So when I was younger, I used to hang out with a lot of my older homies. And like they used to bring me out to like all these different parties. And that kind of like brought me into this like nightlife culture in San Francisco. With like, it was a little different. It wasn't all about like bottle popping and like all that stuff. It was more like very organic, and you get to see like the Bay Area culture like expand. So I thought that was really cool. And then I met a lot of like-minded folks, a lot of DJs, a lot of like bartenders, like everybody. And then I went home and I messed around on this thing called virtual DJ. That's like a free DJ app. My homie Will showed me how to use it. And this was when I was like kind of in college. And then at college, I'd be throwing house parties and just kind of be using the virtual DJ to play music. And I was like, man, this is really dope. So after that, I kind of just like got into it. So day by day, one thing led to another, and you know, here we are.
Wow, that's awesome, man. So it was just an app on like online, that a browser app or something?
Yeah, I think I just like downloaded it on the Apple Store. Mm-hmm. And then my homie just showed me how to use it. Mm-hmm. And then we just went from there. Went from virtual DJ to all my DJs. I went from virtual DJ to Serato. So that was like my graduation point.
Okay. Yeah. That's awesome, man. And what type of music do you like to spin usually?
You know, I grew up with a lot of hip hop, rap, R&B. Mm-hmm. So that's something that I started spinning with. But yeah, I had a lot of love for music as like a whole. And I think that's like very big for me. So yeah. I mean, I listen to a lot of like alternative music. Growing up, you know, I turned like all like Green Day, things like that. And then I got into EDM later on. My homie showed me into trap music.
Okay.
So like that got me into EDM. So I think like right now I'm just trying to do a lot of open format. It's like bring everything together. And I think that makes it a lot funner too, you know. And then right now I'm like super into like house music. Mm-hmm. I feel like house music, super fun to play.
So like, you do anything, right?
Yeah. So I had a lot of homies that go to a lot of house events. Mm-hmm. So like they kind of brought me into this like community, because I feel like the house community is very different from like going to like hip hop shows and things like that. So we went to a lot of like Dirty Bird events. Mm-hmm. And that kind of made my love for house even more. So shout out Pagat. I know, but yeah.
That's dope, man. Yeah, I've seen you at just up and coming from different events, smaller venues to now larger venues, mezzanine as well as grand, right? You've been doing it all, man.
RIP to the mezzanine, but yeah.
That's awesome, dude. So I'm curious, man, Friends. You're DJ MikeWoo, but how did Friends come about exactly?
Yeah, so Friends is just kind of like this creative collective that I'm kind of pushing for. Mm-hmm. It's just like me and my homies that like, we're just trying to do really dope stuff. Mm-hmm. This thing kind of originated like 2 years ago pretty much. And this is where like, you know, when you're with your homies, like it's like no judgment. Like when you see something dope, or like see something new, like you're excited to show your homie. Like when you're in the car playing music on the aux cord, you're like, this is something new. So like, you know that feeling? Like that's something that we really want to cultivate, where like whenever we're throwing events under as a Friends event, we want to like cultivate this culture where it's like no judgment. You know, you come out with your homies, you have fun. You know, it's not labeled as a certain thing, but it's more so like, you know, let's come out here, have fun.
It's like good vibes only, right?
Yeah, good vibes. Any type of music goes, anything goes pretty much, you know. But like the no judgment zone.
Just come out, have a good time, just always throw that party and just feel the vibes out.
Yeah, exactly. Like definitely. So that's something that we're doing. So Friends, like on a logistical aspect, like we do a lot of happy hours. So we do happy hours at like Hometown Heroes. Mm-hmm. We kind of stopped throwing events for right now, but We're still pushing out and collabing with different people, different DJs, so events. So just check us out.
For sure, we'll definitely plug that in. Just tell me some of the struggles that you went through as a DJ or just up and coming, like, into this industry, man.
Yeah, definitely. So I think just up and coming, like, it was very organic for me. I met a lot of like people, the like-minded people like earlier that I mentioned. So that helped me get into like this area, like the culture of DJing. I learned a lot from like the older people. However, I feel like right now there's like so much talent in the Bay Area that you need to figure out like what to do to like kind of stand out.
Exactly.
And like, are you doing the right events? Like, are you doing this for yourself or are you like doing this just to like chase clout and things like that? And I think another thing that really annoyed me was kind of getting labeled into like a certain category. So like, oh, this is an Asian party, or like this is like a Asian DJ, you know? And I think that got kind of annoying at some point, but you know, it's like, it will happen regardless of what area that you're in, but like, you just need to diversify your crowd, you know, like be open to everything. And I think that's kind of what helped out. But yeah, man, just trying to like stand out in a place where there's so much talent and so much like culture and everything going on at the same time.
Yeah, definitely a lot of noise, and you just gotta be different to really stand out, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I feel like don't be scared to like just do something different, you know, like kind of make your own lane. I know it's a lot easier to say than do.
Yeah. Yeah. So what made you like take that leap of faith, man? I know that's a big jump, right?
Yeah. I think honestly, you just if you keep doing something over and over again, you kind of see like what's going right, what's going wrong. A lot of my older homies, my older DJ heads, like told me to take a step back and I really reevaluate yourself here and there, you know? Because there's people that constantly go like every party, like next party, every weekend. But I feel like you kind of need to take a step back and just be like, all right, what the fuck are we doing? Can I swear on this?
Yeah,
sure. Yeah, but like, it's just like, what are you doing? And like, how can we like be different and like do something for the community? Like, you know, like,
got it. Provide more value.
Yeah,
right?
Like, what's your value in it? Like, if you want to keep throwing lit parties, that's dope. But if you want to throw parties that do something for the community, get in that lane. Like, there's so much things that you could do with events. So sure. I feel like,
that's dope, man. It seems like you had some great mentors, man. And you know, how'd you find those mentors?
Man, I think just like at a young age, just like going out that kind of helped me out, you know? Like, that's kind of frowned upon. But like, you know, I was just out and I just met a lot of people. So like, when I was younger, it was just like, I remember going to like a lot of the Candy Rain parties at like Edinburgh, like Sellers at Beauty Bar and like another party fan parties. And, like, this is kind of like what I really wanted to do. And like that culture was like so cool to me when I was growing up. And then I think that really helped me get into like what I'm doing right now. But also like I met like Trung, who was kind of like, who took me under his wing and like brought me into like a lot of different aspects too. So like just like meeting people, I think here and there, being able to network yourself, like don't be a weirdo, you know, but at the same time, just like go support people. I think that's like, that helps out a lot.
Yeah, I think I really respect that, man. It's a community that you're building, right?
Yeah, like building out your network, and having fun. I feel like that's the main thing, just have fun.
That's dope, man. Any tips for like the young entrepreneurs or DJs out there, man?
Yeah, I feel like I'm still part of that young category. But, you know, just like, I feel like just supporting. Go out to different events, especially for DJs. Don't go to just like one party over and over again. Like, try to check out all these different parties. And then just like go, don't be a weirdo, but like introduce yourself, meet people. Yeah. Like, don't be just on your phone and like following everyone on Instagram and DMing them, but like just actually go to the party, go support them, you know? And I think that goes a long way. Like, if someone comes out to my parties, they don't ask me for shit, they just come up to me and say, what's up? And you're a cool ass dude, like, of course we're gonna like link up later down the line. It might not be next week, but eventually it's gonna happen.
Yeah, it just comes around, everything comes around. So that's really dope, man. And you know, I really respect what you're doing over here, and I know you're balancing a lot of things too, so
yeah,
mad respect, dude.
Thank you.
What were some of the biggest motivations for you to really do this, man? And I know you spoke briefly on your influences too.
I think like motivation wise, you know, because I feel like in this certain realm or like this certain aspect, like it's like a lot of up and downs. You know, you can have a really dope weekend or a really dope DJ set like one night, and then the next night could just be like really shitty.
Yeah.
You know, so like just like I feel like it's like it was pretty hard on me. Like I got a lot of anxiety like over here and there, like a fear of failure.
Mm-hmm.
So like what really motivated me is just like be around like good people, I think. Like being around really good friends, really good like homies, like that helps out a lot. I like hang out with like my friends Mendoza and Kelvin, who all DJ as well. And like we go to dinner every Wednesday night, and like we just like talk shit. Like we talk so much shit.
Yeah.
And they always cap on me because I'm the youngest one, but like that makes me motivated to like do better. I like see what they're doing. Like they run the parties function, and then Kelvin runs like bass laps and like R&B and ribs. But like when I see that, I'm be like, oh cool, you're talking shit on me, and like I get hella sensitive, but at the same time you're just like fuck, like,
I know what you mean.
You're just like fuck, I gotta do better, or like
you gotta step up your game.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah.
You're like, wow.
And then like, you know, when you talk it over with some people, like people that actually care about you and stuff, like that's gonna push you, you know. So I think that helps out. Another motivation is like I talked about it earlier.
Mm-hmm.
If you like go to like different things, I feel like you see such a different world. So
yeah,
there's like I was in like house music, I was into like rap music and all stuff like that. But like there's like a Motown Monday party, and it's just like what the fuck, this is a whole different world. And like
totally different.
Yeah, or like a Saison Libre party with like reggaeton music, and like I have no idea what any of the words mean in the songs, but yep. It's lit, and like people
you're absorbing
are
everything. You're like
the
damn.
Energy there is probably like the best energy I've ever seen. Like no one's on the phone, people are dancing.
That's dope. Yeah.
Yeah, so
that's music, man. Like it speaks all languages.
So I feel like that hella helps out with me and keep me motivated, keep me fresh, keep me on my toes. So,
nice, man. You gotta have those people out there just to really support you and those different influences, man.
Yeah, man. And like all the older homies too, like they be checking in on you, and like, you know, like you wanna like kind of follow their footsteps. Kind of like DJ wise and like just in life too. There's like an older DJ that really always looks out after the younger homies too. Shout out Sean G. He checks up on you just here and there, so that's love. That's like mad love over there. So that's another motivation factor too. So.
Oh, for sure.
Yeah,
man.
Yeah.
That's mad respect. Nice. So, I mean, what do you think, or who do you think was your biggest influence?
Man, I feel like right now, saying this in like the most genuine possible, like nothing like really influences me right now. I feel like just like being not a person, but like just being in an environment, kind of like how I talked about earlier, like being in new environments, experiencing new things, definitely is like an influence for you. But yeah, I talked about in the past like all the different parties that I used to go to, like that was kind of just like what fueled me. And also just seeing like people do like dope stuff. You know, they say like Instagram is like very bad, like it could like it alters like your perspective on life. But like when I see a lot of people doing dope stuff, or like they're grinding it out, like I mean I feel like that makes you want to like better yourself. So I feel like it's a give and take.
Yeah, I totally agree. I mean, if you're spending all day just scrolling, that becomes kind of, you know, mindless, right? And
yeah.
Not being productive.
No, I feel right? Like sometimes like I follow like just like accounts that like motivate you or some shit like that, and you know, as corny as it is, like if I don't want to go to the gym and I'm scrolling and I like see like fucking get up and do something,
do it. Just do it, right?
You're gonna do it instead of like scrolling and seeing like
a
chick on your Instagram. But yeah, I think that's
I totally agree, man. Like I absorb a lot of motivational content, but at one point you got to stop absorbing, actually execute.
Yeah, and actually
right?
go do it.
So actually go do it. So MPH is motivation, passion, hustle, but it also stands for miles per hour. Like how fast are you actually going?
Yeah, totally.
Right? So it's all about the execution. It's cool that you know what you know, but you got to execute what you know.
Exactly, definitely.
Right? That's power, right?
Man,
there.
Man, that's like a rhyme over there. But yeah, that's dope.
Yeah. So yeah, how do you balance everything, man? I know you're working a 9-to-5 and you're balancing with the gigs and DJing here?
Yeah, it does get tiring, mm-hmm. but I feel like I just have like mad OCD. Mm-hmm. So just like being able to schedule out your day to like the smallest points. You know, like sometimes like I schedule out my day where like I have a hard cut at like 4 at work.
Yeah.
And after that, like I even schedule like 30 minutes to travel home and then hour to prep like
your everything.
Set. Like literally everything. And then that helps me like see like my everyday. It's kind of like a checklist. Uh-huh. So I get like satisfaction of like finishing stuff. Cause you know, sometimes like,
oh yeah,
go to the gym. That shit, like I don't want to do that shit at 9:30, but like I need to check that shit off my, my like calendar. So like that kind of pushes me to do it. Another thing that I kind of learned is just like knowing like how big your plate is, and like mm-hmm. like you can't always be a yes man or like agree to do this or agree to do that. Mm-hmm. So just like prioritizing like what you like want to do, what's important to you, and like things like that, I think it helps out.
Yeah, most definitely. I'm learning that right now. Usually I just want to please everyone, right? People pleasing, but you got to realize you have 24 hours in a day and you really got to get all your shit done first, right?
Yeah.
And then you can expend time.
Yeah, and I feel like you just learn that like just by staying busy and just like trial and error.
Yeah.
And just trying to make like the best of like your day helps out a lot. You know, because like this is like something that I'm starting to learn right now. And it's just like, dude, when you're out partying like on a Friday, and you need to like do hella shit on Saturday. There's been so
like
many
today.
Days. Yeah, like today. Like this is like 11 a.m. right now. But
yeah.
Like waking up hungover and just being in bed all day, like that fucks up your whole fucking weekend schedule.
I agree.
So, yeah. So like just, I mean, at first when I first started spinning and stuff, like I was just out and just fucking partying, yeah. and like the next day, like I would just wake up like hungover in bed
city.
All day. Like not doing shit, like hella anxiety, like so I think like that another like so that kind of fucks up your schedule. So like being smart about like what you're doing helps out definitely. Mm-hmm. I'm not the best at that on the weekends, but you know, like we're getting there, you know.
We all have to try, you know.
Yeah, we're all trying.
Definitely, man. I set those reminders on my calendar too, from like 8 to 10 after gym. Be productive, right? Like, what are you doing? What are you educating yourself on, you know?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And I think, like, just like, you know, like, I'm commuting a lot right now, so, like, I'm not able to read physically. Mm-hmm. So, like, just like listening to, like, podcasts and, like, audio
same
books,
here.
Like, that's like killing two, what?
Two birds, one stone.
Yeah. Two birds and one stone.
Yep.
Or, I like, agree. Yeah, like, listen to a podcast while you're working out. I think you're the one that told me about it. Like, you're on a Stairmaster and like listen to a podcast.
Yeah, listen to vlogs or like listen to a podcast and just like zone out and just learn something new, right?
Yeah, so I mean that's like dope too, so yeah.
Cool, man. So tell me, man, what's your plans for the future? Like what's your 1 year plan, 3 year plan, 5 year
yeah,
plan?
I mean I have a couple shows coming up. I wanna say soon. Like we got Valentine's Day coming up with like literally all my homies are spinning. At 10:15 at Smino.
Okay.
So that should be tight. We have Cyber Rodeo coming up, their 1 year anniversary. Love that party. Shout out Baby J, Kawasaki, like all the people at Cyber Rodeo.
Okay.
But I think just like later down the line, I'm just trying to keep pushing friends. So shout out to Sean and Tommy. We need to put in some work. Just put out more content.
Nice. We'll put some links in.
Yeah. Put out more content, and like we're trying to build out a monthly right now. I've been getting a lot of shit for not having a monthly, and people that are giving me shit know who they when they see this, like they know who they are. But so we're trying to build out a monthly party right now, kind of like an open format monthly party. So hopefully that is in the works.
Okay.
Like a really big dream of mine is like I kind of want to do like a day. Festival,
a day festival, kind of like Coachella, or
yeah, but not like to extent, but like in the Bay, like in San Francisco. I feel like I know so many artists and like talented people that like we could all come together and just like have a day to showcase something to like all our homies and stuff.
So like a big collab, right?
Yeah, just like a huge collab. You know, like everyone's always like, "Yo, let's build, let's work, fam. Yep. This is the place you can build."
That is dope.
So I mean that. Would be a pretty big thing that we should do. Maybe it's in the works right now, maybe
yeah,
it's
man.
Not.
Definitely supportive of that, man. Hopefully we get some more viewership from people watching this video and they would support the Bay Area artists, right?
Yeah, and I think just like doing more dope collabs later down the line, expanding like my collective with other people, Like how we're doing a collab right now, you know, I never thought I was going to be on a YouTube channel.
shout out, man.
Shout out, YouTube.
I appreciate you, MikeWoo.
But yeah, you know, just keep doing dope stuff and like keep pushing out content. I think content is like the biggest thing right now for everyone.
Yeah, I mean, that's part of why I started this channel, man. I wanted to showcase like Bay Area artists like that are up and coming and that are doing it too. I feel like sometimes we get lost with all the noise in the background sometimes, but we really need to showcase ourselves, right, with content. So I'm super happy that you were here with me and just really came through on a moment's notice, man.
Yeah, totally, man. Thank you.
Yeah, so tell the viewers where we can find you, man.
Yeah, you know, you can find me at all the shows, so I expect everyone watching this to be at the show. but no, on a real note, we have Instagram.
Okay.
My personal Instagram is Will It's Mike. We have Friends SF Instagram. You can find me like over there. On a professional level, you know, you can find me on LinkedIn.
All right, click the link below.
Oh yeah, you know, all the recruiters out there, you know, if you got something going on, you know, DM me on LinkedIn, we'll talk.
Always prospect.
Yeah, but yeah, man, I mean, you guys find me over there. I'm always around, I'm out and about, you know.
All right, well, it sounds good, man. Thank you so much for chilling with me, man.
Yeah, of course, man. Thank you for having me here. Just one more thing, you know, shout out Hometown Bull, shout out Trung, shout out everyone at the Hometown staff for letting us use the space. So yeah,
thank you guys, I really appreciate it. We'll send you guys this video too.
Cool, man.
Hey, if you guys enjoyed this episode of MPH, like, comment, and subscribe. It would really help us out. Really appreciate it. Shout out. Thank you.